3, 2, 1.
Forget everything that you know about aquariums, because after this video, you're going to realize the way most people make fish tank is like using a horse instead of a car in the 21st century. Let me show you. Look at this normal, healthy aquarium, right? The plants are growing, everything looks stable, nothing crazy. But I have a question for you. If I took all the water out of this tank, and then I flip the tank upside down, what would happen? A, all the plants and substrate fall to the ground, a total disaster. B, everything stays perfectly in place. Or C, something else happened. Lock your answer. If you choose A, you're wrong. The correct answer is B. Everything stayed perfectly intact. No glue, no fishing line, no moving magic. Just a very different way of thinking about aquariums. Today, I'm going to show you how this works. Why the plants don't fall, and how this system may replace traditional fish tanks forever. Nothing will happen. For over hundreds of years, aquariums have basically worked like this. You take the tank and you pour substrate at the bottom, and then you stick the plants into it. But what is the problem with this, you ask? Fish poop, uneaten food, and waste sink down into that layer. Over time, it all gets trapped there.
Here.
And if you have planted tanks before, you know what happens. Every time you move a plant, you create a mess. Cleaning a tank means fighting against the substrate. If you want to change the layout, you basically have to destroy everything and start over. It works, but it's not exactly smart. So instead of trying to fix the same old system, I decided to do something different. What if the plants didn't actually live at the bottom of the fish tank at all? The answer to that upside down experiment is this. A simple looking 3D printer modular container with a sponge lid. I know, it looks almost too simple, but behind this little box, there is a reason why the plants stay healthy and don't care if they're upright or upside down. Let me show you how it works. Each module is a container that you fill halfway with substrate. Seal with a sponge lid that is half an inch thick. And that sponge lid has these little slits cut into it. Those slits are where the magic happens. You gently push the plants through one of the slits, so the stem passes through the sponge and reaches down into the substrate. And this makes the planting so easy and fast. Now, here's the key. The sponge is elastic. When you deform it and push the plant in, the sponge wants to return to its original shape. That creates a natural gripping force around the stem, like a soft, flexible hand holding the plant in place. To the plant, it feels like it's planted in a super stable, heavy substrate. The result? The plant responds by growing more roots, anchoring itself even deeper and thriving. And because the substrate inside the modules is made of small ball granules that are larger than the pores of the sponge, the substrate stays trapped inside the container. This is a prototype sample that I made and explained really well how everything works. A container with substrate inside, a sponge as a lid that you can add plant and put it in your tank. It doesn't leak into the tank, it doesn't cloud the water, it doesn't explode everywhere when you move things around. So now you don't have the substrate at the bottom of the tank. You have a contained ecosystem floor made of planting blocks that just happen to sit on the bottom, for now. That's why I can flip the whole tank upside down and the plants don't care. Here is where the things start to feel illegal. If you get planted tanks before, want to re-scape your aquarium? You don't uproot anything. You don't create a sandstorm. You just do this. And that's it. The plant layout now lives in blocks, like Lego for aquariums. You can move everything around without destroying the roots, and you can test different layouts in seconds. And because everything is self-contained, you can do something that is normally impossible. You can ship a fully planted aquarium floor. Imagine this. You set up your modules at home, the plants grow for a few weeks, and the roots establish. Then you take the modules out, put it in a box, ship it across the country. When it arrives, the person receiving it doesn't get a plastic plant or a bag of loose gravel. They get a living, ready-to-go planted aquarium. They put it into their tank, filled with water, healthy plants, rooted, stable, instantly. You can do the same thing between your own aquariums. New tank, move the modules over. Bigger tank, add more modules. Changing a theme, swap the decoration on top of the modules without disturbing the root system below. This turns your aquarium from a fixed sculpture into a modular system that you can rearrange without destroying it every time. And we are still not done, because once the plants are inside the containers, you are free to rethink something else: filtration. These containers are not just boxes. They are designed to work together with a pipe system at the bottom. The modules sit slightly elevated, and underneath them is a system of channels that redirect the water flow down to the bottom of the aquarium. That changes everything. Normally, waste and fish poop sink at the bottom of the tank and just sit there. They hide in the substrate and you fight them during every water change. With this system, water gets pulled across the bottom of the tank under the modules. Waste and poop never get the chance to settle. The flow pushes debris toward the intake, where it can actually be filtered out. Your plants are happy, your substrate is contained, and your fish is not swimming over a landfill. And maintenance? You can lift the modules out, wipe the glass, vacuum any leftover debris, put the modules back. No replanting, no crying over a destroyed aquascape. So let's go back to the beginning. Why does this matter? Because for decades, aquariums have been built on the same idea. You put substrate at the bottom, you stick the plants to it, and hope it works. It works, but it's fragile, hard to maintain, and really unforgiving for beginners, kids, and everyone who doesn't want to fight their tank every week. This modular system changes that. Plants think that they are in a strong and stable substrate. Roots grow deeper and healthier. Substrate stays where it belongs. Filtration becomes smarter and more efficient.
You can ship, swap, move, and change the layout of your aquarium without destroying it.
That to me is the difference between the horse and the car. Both will move you forward, but only one is built for the world we live in now. I have been experimenting this modular planting system to make aquariums easier to maintain, more portable, and way more fun to play with. But now I want to know what you think. Will you use something like this in your aquarium? Do you think this could replace traditional gravel in the hobby? Or do you see some limitations that I haven't thought about it yet? Let me know in the comments. I'm reading all of them. If you want to see this crazy modular system in a theme tank, make sure you subscribe so you don't miss it. And this is just the beginning. Forget everything that you know about aquariums, because we're not doing horse anymore. We're building the future of fish tanks. See you next time.